Hello everyone, how are you today? I hope everybody is fine and safe. This time I will present to you the sample performance monitoring and coaching form or PMCF with annotation on the RPMS objective number 9 para sa ating mga master teachers. Advice and guided colleagues in the selection, organization, development and use of appropriate teaching and learning resources including ICT to address specific learning goals. Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Mr. Jem Raimonis Chen, Master Teacher 2 from Escalante Central Elementary School. Click like and share if this video tutorial helps you. Don't forget to click subscribe below to keep updated for my future tutorial. Ito na nga po yung mga MOVs para sa quality na indicator para sa ating RPMS objective number 9 for our highly proficient teachers. At para nga makakuha ng rating of 5 si Master Teacher on this particular RPMS objective, ang kinakailangan niyang MOV na isusuport ay ang Performance Monitoring and Coaching Form and take note with annotations highlighting the objective. And also, hindi lang quality kundi i-rate din si Master Teacher on RPMS objective number 9 sa timeliness. At para makakuha ng rating of 5 sa timeliness si Master Teacher para sa objective na to, kinakailangang mapakita niya na he or she was able to guide his or her colleague in the selection, organization, development, and use of appropriate teaching and learning resources, including ICT to address specific learning goals across 4 quarters. So, pwede naman itong makita kasi yung PMCF ay may date naman talaga na required na dapat ilagay. At ito na nga po yung template ng ating performance monitoring and coaching form. And ito naman po yung template ng ating annotation. Now, let's have an example. Again, teachers, para ito sa RPMS objective number 9 na advise and guide colleague in the selection, organization, development, and use of appropriate teaching and learning resources, including ICT to address specific learning goals. Ang ipinapakita ko sa inyo ay isang halimbawa lamang. And let's have PMCF appropriate for a grade 1 teacher teaching mathematics. Ang nakikita nyo ngayon ay nangyari on the first quarter and the lesson of the teacher was on week 5 and this is about read and write numbers up to 100 in symbols and in words. So this is the sample PMCF for that particular learning objective. Ito naman yung pangalawang entry ng ating PMCF and this is an example of an entry happened in the second quarter. Still, our mathematics teacher in grade 1, same teacher po. Okay? Week 1 on the second quarter and the lesson is about illustrates addition as putting together or combining or joining sets. And the master teacher here was able to guide or advise the colleague or his or her mentee in selecting and organizing and use of appropriate teaching and learning resources for the said learning goals. Ito naman po yung parang follow-up ni Master Teacher. Still happened in the second quarter with the same learning objective na illustrating addition as putting together or combining or joining sets. So this time, this happened in the third quarter. And this is the fourth quarter, and the lesson of the teacher here is to determine the day or the month using a calendar. And this is quarter 4, week 2 math lesson in grade 1. So, ito na nga po yung ating PMCF para sa ating mathematics teacher sa grade 1. And this shows across 4 quarters as required to get rating of 5 sa timeliness. Makikita naman po natin yan sa date na column. Now, gamitin natin itong performance monitoring and coaching form na nagawa natin para gawan ito ng annotation. Better po to write annotation in each entry ng ating PMCF. Now, this is the sample annotation para sa first entry na nilagay natin sa ating PMCF. Still, this is about the RPMS objective number 9 ng ating mga master teacher that advise, guide colleagues in the selection, organization, development and use of appropriate teaching and learning resources, including ICT, to address specific learning goals. Now, para naman sa second entry na nilagay natin sa PMCF, ito naman yung katumbas na annotation for that entry. And para naman sa third entry na nilagay natin sa ating PMCF, ito naman yung sample annotation para doon. Now, para naman sa fourth entry ng ating PMCF, ito naman yung sample annotation. And the fifth and the final entry ng ating PMCF, ito naman yung sample annotation. Again, Ito na po yung kabuuan na annotation para sa ating RPMS objective number 9. Again, kinakailangan itong i-attach sa ating PMCF na nagawa. Sana yung video na to nakatulong sa inyo at nabigyan kayo ng idea how to make the PMCF with annotation para sa ating objective number 9 for our highly proficient teachers. That's all for this video and see you next time. Keep safe, everyone!